Greetings. Thank you, Brother Salim, for your question. The verse says, try the spirits, whether they are of God. Spirits mentioned in plural, so you believe in many Holy Ghosts? That's the first question. And you say also that Holy Ghost is God, so you believe in many gods? Any Christian can explain? Thank you for the great question, brother. Let's look carefully at your question and see where there may be some misunderstandings. You asked, the verse says, try the spirits, whether they are of God. Spirits mentioned in plural, so you believe in many Holy Ghosts. I think the first point we should cover is the word spirit, because this appears to be a source of confusion. The word spirit has several definitions you need to be aware of. 1. The non-physical part of a person that is the seat of emotions and character. Some common secular definitions include soul, psyche, mind, ego, id, and pneuma, which is the Greek. But there is a second usage that also occurs. Those qualities, regarded as forming the definitive or typical elements in the character of a person, or nation, or group. For example, a spirit of giving means a character trait of generosity, not an entity who forces giving. Think of it as meaning an attribute someone may have, such as school spirit, which may mean pride in your educational institution. There is also a verb form of the word meaning to convey rapidly and secretly. For example, the king was spirited away after the protester threw a shoe. But I am pretty confident this is not the definition used in this verse. Let's look at this particular verse and then talk about what it means with the knowledge of these definitions, brother. 1 John 4:1. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. In this first phrase, believe not every spirit, it is clearly using definition 1, meaning an entity and not an attribute. In the teaching of the Torah and Bible, there are multiple kinds of spirits. There are angels, and there are demons, which are angels who have sinned or fallen. Human beings are also called spirits, using definition 1. Our spirit is our essence, who we really are. But in this verse, it is not speaking of humans and the spirits of the humans. Believe not every spirit, but try the spirits. The word try means to examine or prove or approve by testing or scrutinize. So we are to examine and evaluate and judge the spirits who tell us things to believe. Whether they are of God. This means whether they are from God. Because many false prophets are gone out into the world. This phrase is not meant to confuse a prophet as a spirit. In fact, this very thing confuses Islamic scholars Didat and Naik. In the first part of this verse, the words spirit and spirits are used. Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God. Then, in the final phrase, the word prophets is used, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. But this does not mean a prophet is a synonym for spirit, or spirit for prophet. The necessary knowledge is that a prophet is a human who speaks for a spirit. A prophet speaks a message sent from a spirit. A true prophet brings a true message from God, who is a spirit. A false prophet brings a false message from a false spirit. You evaluate the spirit who sent the prophet by examining the message. You asked, The verse says, try the spirits whether they are of God. Spirits mentioned in plural, so you believe in many holy ghosts. There are several verses in Revelation which Muslim teachers will reference that adds to their confusion, brother. Revelation 1:4, John, to the seven churches that are in Asia, grace to you and peace from him who is, and who was, and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne. This verse also does not mean there are seven holy spirits. This may mean seven angels, each of which guards or represents these seven churches. I specifically say may because the absolute meaning is not clear. However, it is clear that this does not mean seven holy spirits. Revelation 3:1, and to the messenger of the church in Sardis write, these things says the one having the seven spirits of God and the seven stars. I know your deeds, that you have the characterization that you are alive, and yet you are dead. Some may want to try and claim this does mean seven holy spirits. But that makes less sense than simply applying definition 2. Definition 2, those qualities regarded as forming the definitive or typical elements in the character of a person or nation or group. When we read the original verse, notice this is actually describing the One. These things says the One. Well, which one? That question is answered in the description that follows. These things says the One having the seven spirits of God. Now this makes total sense when read with definition 2. The One having the seven attributes of God. And you would be perfectly correct to ask and wonder, what are these seven attributes of God it speaks of? I believe these may have been revealed by Prophet Isaiah. Isaiah 11:2, the Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and strength, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. In this verse, we see mention of seven spirits or characteristics, attributes of Yahweh, the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord, that's one, will rest on him. The Spirit of wisdom, that's two, and understanding, that's three. The Spirit of counsel, that's four, and strength, that's five. And the Spirit of knowledge, six, and the fear of the Lord, that's seven. So that verse applies definition 2. The spirits are attributes or characteristics. And these seven attributes of God will rest on the person being described. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him. But let's respect the context and dig a little deeper, brother. Who is Isaiah talking about in verse 11:2? Isaiah 11:1, and there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. Glory to God, brother. This is a prophecy of Messiah. The Messiah will have these seven attributes of Yahweh, God. And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and strength, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. So now, when we read Revelation 3:1, we know the One who has the seven spirits of God resting on him. These things says the One having the seven spirits of God and the seven stars. These things says the Messiah who has the seven attributes of God resting on him. Thank you, brother, for your great question. I hope that you contemplate the meaning that the Messiah himself has the seven attributes of God resting on him. You also asked, and you say also that Holy Ghost is God, so you believe in many gods. I would love to answer this, brother, and will in the next video as time permits. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.